Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are discussing one important hadith. Hadith from Sahih Muslim. The post is given here. وَحَدَّثَنِي حَرْمَلَةَ بْنُ يَحْيَى التجيبي. Then سعيد بن المسيب عن أبيه. That is سعيد بن المسيب رضي الله عنه reports from his father that فلما حضرت أبا طالب الوفاة جاءه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فوجد عنده أبا جهل وعبد الله بن أبي أمية بن المغيرة. حديث لما حضرت أبا طالب when أبو طالب was about to die, that is signs of death appeared, then جاءه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم came to him, came near him. فوجد عنده, then he found there near him, near his uncle Abu Talib. So we know Abu Talib was the uncle of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he used to help Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He used to protect him from his enemies, but he didn't believe in Tawheed, in Islam. He didn't embrace Islam. Then that was his last moments of his life. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came there, and then there he saw Abu Jahl, Abdullah ibn Abi Umayyah ibn al-Mughira. Abu Jahl and Mughira's son, Abdullah ibn Abi Mughira's son, Abu Umayyad's son, Abdullah also was there. That is, two mushrikeen were there near Abu Talib, who was about to die. Then, فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم asked or said, called to his uncle Abu Talib, يَا أَمِّ قُلْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ كَلِمَةً أَشْهَدُ لَكَ بِهَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. يَا أَمِّ, oh my uncle, قُلْ, you say, La ilaha illallah, there is no God except Allah. Kalimatan, a word, a sentence, ashhadu laka, I can testify upon you, biha, with that word, that is with the kalima, tawheed, La ilaha illallah, I can testify indallah, near Allah, or before Allah, I can testify that you are a true believer, you are a believer. Okay. Then فقال أبو جهل وعبد الله بن أبي أمية يا أبا طالب أترغب عن ملة عبد المطلب. Then أبو جهل and عبد الله بن أبي أمية asked to أبو طالب, و أبو طالب, are you going to give up the religion of عبد المطلب? Are you going to give up, avoid the religion of عبد المطلب? Then فلم يزل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يغرضها عليه ويعيد له تلك المقالة حتى قال أبو طالب آخر ما كلمهم هو على ملة عبد المطلب. Then this conversation continued. This رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم asked or requested أبو طالب to say لا إله إلا الله. That is to become his last words, La ilaha illallah. That is to be a Muslim. He longed for that. But Abu Jahl asked to continue. Abu Jahl and Abdullah ibn Abi Umayyad asked to continue. What? That is, are you going to give up the religion of Abdul Muttalib? The religion of Shirk. Okay? Then. And قال أبو طالب آخر ما كلمهم هو على ملة عبد المطلب وأبى أن يقول لا إله إلا الله. But أبو طالب finally said that he is in the millet, in the deen of عبد المطلب, and in the deen of, that is in the deen of polytheism, and not, he refused to say, that is لا إله إلا الله. He refused to say لا إله إلا الله. Then فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ama wallah ila astaghfiranna laka ma lam unha anka. That is, I will be continuing to ask istighfar, that is, to continuing to ask forgiveness for you, that is, for my uncle Abu Talib, till I will be prohibited by Allah. That is not true. Not true. Ask forgiveness for his mushrik uncle. Then, فَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلِّ Then Allah Azza wa Jal revealed these verses. What was that verse? That is in Surah At-Tawbah.
مَكَالَ لِلنَّبِي وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُوا لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ مَكَالَ لِلنَّبِيِّ
It is not meet or it is not suitable, it is not needed for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا and to those who are true believers أَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُوا to ask istighfar or to ask forgiveness للمشركين for the polytheist ولو كانوا أولي قربا even if they are close relatives of them that is here Abu Talib is the close relative of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he wanted him to be a Muslim at least during his last moments but he refused still Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said I will ask forgiveness to Allah for you till I will be prohibited or prevented from doing so by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, revealed these verses, that is, مَا كَالَ لِلنَّبِيِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُوا لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ It is not obligatory or it is not needed for the Prophet or the true believers to ask forgiveness for the polytheists even if they are their close relatives مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ after it is made clear to them that is this deen al-islam is clear this is haqq this is truth so those who want they can accept those who need it they can accept they can embrace it there is no need of compulsion so if one is not willing to accept the religion of islam then Muslims should not ask istighfar or seek forgiveness from Allah to the polytheists. Okay. Then, مِن بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ After it is explained to them, أَنَّهُمْ certainly they belongs to أصحاب الجحيم, the people of hellfire. That is, after death, if one dies as a mushrik, as a polytheist, he will be brought to the hellfire. He will be put into the hellfire. That should be explained to them. And it is not compulsory upon them to accept. They have the freedom to accept or reject. Okay. But if it is rejected, they will be put in the hellfire. It should be explained to them. Okay. Then, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ Then, Allah also said these words also to the Messenger of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّكَ لَا تَخْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَخْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ إِنَّكَ certainly you are. لَا تَخْدِي You cannot guide people. مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ Those whom you love. Those whom you have affection. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ But it is Allah. But it is Allah. يَخْدِي He guides. مَنْ يَشَاءُ Whom he wills. Okay. Then, وَاللَّهُ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ And he can know well who is guided well. Okay. Then, so this is the hadith. So, from this, we can understand that even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam cannot guide people whom he loved. Okay. Allah only can guide. So, Allah has given the freedom. We can use that freedom positively or negatively.